All right. Okay, 100, 200, 300, and 50.
You're 50 quid short, sir.
Oh, come on, give us a break. I'm an old customer. I deserve a discount.
In your dreams.
400. Oh, very tasty.
Certainly look the part.
Thank you very much, sir.
What else we got on you?
Kilo cocaine, set of scales, and a signed statement from a buyer. I'm in the frame.
Just so long as you confess, Vicky. What we don't need is no comment all the way through.
What if that's what Kemp Jones tells me to do?
With you looking at 6 years minimum, he's going to know you'll be wanting to jump bail.
We hope. Now, you know the rules on entrapment?
Yes, Gov.
Wait for Kemp Jones to offer you the passport. Don't nudge him unless you have to.
Yes, Gov.
Gov, with respect, he's not going to need nudging. And he's sold 3 dodgy passports to clients that we know of. There's no reason why he shouldn't do the same with you.
What about the money? Have you got that sorted?
Money's in my account, Gov. If needs be, I can get that this afternoon.
Well, let's hope we move that quickly. All right, give me a shout when he arrives.
So who's in on it?
Well, it's you, me, Deakin and Ackland, Miller Blake at the front desk, and that's it. Oh, not forgetting Boyden, and whoever is your jailer, of course.
Of course. What if someone comes into custody?
Don't worry, Boyden will close it down. There's no chance that anyone will recognise you.
What are you doing here?
Oh, I left something in the office, Sarge.
What?
My diary.
Forgotten what day it is. Go on.
There you are, Sarge. She's all yours.
Is this your outfit?
No, Sarge, it's a new bag.
Well, watch out for him, Vicky.
On your bike. Your catacomb, keep the likes of him out.
Cub, oh, Cub, where you been?
I left something behind.
My first day back on the road, Dave, and you go holding me up.
Sorry, Tone.
Some things don't
all
change,
units,
I suppose.
Sierra Oscar, custody is now closed. All prisoners to Barton Street. I repeat, custody is now closed.
Sir? I just come from custody. It's as empty as a nickety out of Hebrides, apart from Rod Skase and Vicky Hagen.
Vicky? Why, what's going on?
Search me.
Now, Dave, we're in uniform, remember. The mysteries of the world don't concern us.
What were you up to with CID yesterday, Sam?
I was with Rod Skase. He was taking some pictures of me and Vicky Hagen doing a drugs deal.
What, you a druggie?
As it happens.
What do they want him for?
Wouldn't say.
Think it's got something to do with Vicky being in custody?
Could be, I suppose. Anyway, CID wouldn't confide in me. Look, I'm having him.
Step out of the car, please, sir. You ever heard of stopping at a red light?
Amber, you mean? Look, I'm sorry, I'm just in a bit of a hurry, that's all. Look, will you let this one go? I mean, you and me, we're both in the same game.
Are you a copper?
No. Law, I mean.
Solicitor, eh?
Yeah. Go on, mate, turn a blind eye.
Is that what you say to the judges? Driving details.
Very nice. I nearly buy drugs off you myself. What are we calling you?
Mandy Kavanagh.
Kavanagh. Amanda.
Suits her, don't you think?
Definitely. Right. Richard Kemp Jones.
Richard Kemp Jones, solicitor?
Yeah, it's Sergeant Boyden, Sunhill Custody. One of our prisoners asked me to call you.
Yep. Amanda Kavanagh. Right. And the charge? I see.
Sir.
Hold on a second, would you?
Red means stop, right? Make sure you don't use that while you drive.
What is it?
I couldn't believe this, but I think we're being followed.
What?
That Uno.
I don't see no Uno, sir.
Behind a four-wheel drive.
Probably just going in the same direction.
Right. Watch this.
All units from Sierra Oscar, number 2 Lasser Street.
There he is again, look.
It's the Harrises again. Sounds if he's giving you the usual once-over.
Yeah, Sierra Oscar from Sierra 1 on way. Come on, Lasser Street, I've taken the call. Must be those pills you've been taking, Tony.
That's right, Paul.
Excuse me?
It's all in the report.
I'm here to see a client.
Can you hold on a minute, Paul? Could you wait a moment, sir?
I'm expected in custody. Mandy Kavanagh, solicitor.
Look, Paul, I'm going to have to call you back. Okay, bye. Sarge, a Richard Kemp Jones for Mandy Kavanagh.
Right. Cheers, Jamila. It's him.
See you in the interview.
Okay.
Right, better show you to yourself.
Oh!
It's only disinfectant. Your predecessor didn't take kindly to the canteen food.
Oh, can you give us another?
What, the one with a four poster? Sorry, you're in the economy suite. Not writing this lot again. Enjoy your stay with us, Miss Kavanagh.
Mr. Kemp Jones, I'm Deucey Skates.
Sorry, I'm late. Got held up by one of your plods.
Oh, yeah? What for?
Jumping a red light.
Well, that's a uniform for you. Can't even find a real criminal to nick. Shall we go through?
So, Amanda Kavanagh, what's she about?
Possession. Kilo of cocaine. We raided her this morning.
A kilo?
Obviously not just for personal use.
Sergeant.
Afternoon.
Right, now this is what we got her for.
That's in get you around the London Marathon. What else?
Set of scales, traces of powder on the weighing tray. Accounts book listing all of her deals, $2,000 in cash, and photographs of her dealing from her own front doorstep.
Let's see.
Straightforward plea of guilty then, yeah?
Sergeant, better show me to her cell.
This way.
Be quiet in here.
No point in nicking him on with briefs like you around.
Hello, Mandy. I'm Richard Kemp Jones, your solicitor.
I'll leave you to it then.
In case you need to call. How they been treating you, Mandy?
How do you mean?
Well, watered and fed you, that sort of thing.
Whatever it wasn't worth eating.
Okay. Just to get a few details. Your name, Mandy Kavanagh?
Amanda.
Of course. And your address?
11 Tennyson Court.
It's the Larkmead Estate.
Mm-hmm.
East 2. Do you know Don West?
Who?
Your next door neighbour.
What's he got to do with it?
Sorry, Mandy, only asking. You okay?
Yeah.
Seem a bit hyper.
Nothing like this has ever happened before.
You've been getting away with it.
If you like.
Okay, well, let's take this from the beginning, shall we? Obviously you know why you're here.
Yeah.
Well, just to make sure, I'll run through it again. You're under arrest for possession of cocaine. Your arresting officer, D.C. Skase, informs me they found a kilo of the drug in your flat this morning. They've also got scales, an accounts book, photos, cash.
In other words, I'm in it.
Not necessarily. They didn't official, the drugs are for real.
They'll soon find out.
Even so, there's always a line of defence.
Some chance.
Always.
If I went in there and held my hands up, what would I get?
You got no previous?
No.
Even so, you're looking at 6-8 years, depending on the judge.
What if I said I was a junkie?
A kilo, Mandy. It'd be hard to convince them it's for personal use.
6 years.
Don't fancy prison much?
As if.
An attractive young woman like you. Be a waste being locked in a cell. Let's see if we can think our way out of this, shall we?
How do you mean?
And prove that you're innocent. Don't worry, Mandy. You're in good hands.
Well, that was a complete waste of time.
Hello?
Someone's been having a laugh.
Thanks very much.
Oi! Oi! Oi!
For starters, Mandy, tell them you're a prostitute.
What?
It sorts out the sums in your accounts book. Say they're for tricks with your clients. Same with the bloke in the photo, one of your punters.
He didn't come into the house.
Turned him away, busy with another.
And what about the money he gave me?
Paying up front, settling his account.
And that just leaves the drugs.
Gavin Pierce.
What of him?
You know him?
Heard of.
They're his, Mandy. He forced you to look after them. Threatened to harm you when you told him no.
You reckon?
Just the sort of thing he'd do.
Well, then they'll just go and question him.
He's out of the country, Mandy. Done a runner. Wanted on bail for guess what? Dealing cocaine. Your case has got not guilty written all over it.
Surprised there's no pump in these cars, really. That was your Fiat Uno.
Did you get the index?
Sierra Oscar from Sierra One. Sorry, Tony, I didn't.
Go ahead, Dave.
Yeah, a damage only Pollack, Lasser Street.
A Fiat Uno just reversed into us, Sarge.
Didn't get the index. Failed to stop when it hit us.
Damage to the Uno unknown. No witnesses.
Is your car drivable, Dave?
Yeah, well, when we get the wheel back on.
Right, I'll inform the garage, Sergeant.
Nothing more than a scratch, Tone.
Did you see who it was then?
No. No, Tony, I didn't.
All right, Jamila.
So what can I do for you?
The driver of that Audi outside. In here, is he?
Why?
What does he want?
I'm not being funny, Sam, but what's it got to do with you?
Oh, it's just that me and Gary stopped him for jumping a red light. Is he somebody's brief?
Getting a bit nosy, Sam.
The thing is, Rod's case took some photos of me and Vicky Hagen yesterday, but neither of them would tell me what they were for. Now, for whatever reason, everybody knows that custody's closed. But rumour has it that A, custody is empty, and B, Vicky's in there with Rod.
So?
Well, if our mate, Kemp Jones, gets to see those photos of me and Vicky Hagen, he's going to know I'm a copper.
Is this us?
This is Detective Inspector Deakin. We're going to interview your client.
Detective Inspector? Didn't know you were in on this one.
A kilo of cocaine is a big haul for us. Just want to make sure everything goes smooth.
Let's get this sorted.
Right, thanks very much, sir.
Cheers. Shall we go through?
Let's go. This way.
Yes, can I help you?
Let's see DID, can you?
Well, what do you think? You've just seen him go in for an interview. What do you want him for?
It's about Kemp Jones.
My office.
What now, I wonder?
Right, look, slow down a bit, so I'm getting the registration number. Sierra Oscar from Sierra One.
Go ahead, Dave.
Yeah, vehicle check, please, Sarge. Registration Delta 405, November Whiskey, November.
Okay, stand by. Yes, that's a Fiat Uno registered
to Jane Douglas.
Oh, what? I guessed.
No reports.
What are you doing, Tony?
Have this out once and for all.
Look, Hold on, mate. Listen, Tone, it's best if you leave it to somebody else. Tony! You all right, mate?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah?
For the benefit of the tape, I'm showing Mandy Kavanagh exhibit RS1. A plastic bag containing approximately 1 kilo of white powder. Now, Mandy, can you tell us what this white powder is?
Cocaine.
And where did you get it from?
Gavin Pierce.
He's the one who sold it to you?
No.
So how come we found it in your flat?
He forced me to look after it. Said he'd mess up my face with acid if I didn't.
How long have you known Gavin Pierce?
About 3 years.
Friend, is he?
No. A client. I'm a prostitute. Gavin sees me on a regular basis.
So why give you the drugs?
He didn't want to risk taking them abroad.
Where's he gone?
I don't know. Anywhere. He's jumped bail, hasn't he?
What was he up for?
You should know. You nicked him.
When's he coming back?
All I know is I've got a serious problem when he discovers the drugs are gone.
Presuming they're his.
D.I. Deacon, are you inferring my client's lying?
Rod?
For the benefit of the tape, I'm showing Mandy Kavanagh exhibit RS2, which is an accounts book.
Obviously he hasn't sussed you. He would have been out by now.
Yeah, I've still got to tell the D.I. the full story, though.
Oh. Can't we just slip through and wait in the canteen? I'm getting hungry.
Yeah. Sarge?
What?
How long do you reckon they'll be in there? It's just that me and Gary are getting a bit peckish.
What, I've only just started.
There's a bar of chocolate here, someone.
I'll have you two in here for real. Hold on a sec.
For the benefit of the tape, I'm showing Mandy Kavanagh exhibit RS3. Photographs taken on the 10th of this month outside the suspect's flat between 1 and 1:30 p.m.
Can I have a look at this? I'd like to consult with my client. In private.
Interview terminated at 15:41.
Have some water, please.
Right.
And what is the matter with these pictures?
I think we're about to find out.
Sam Harker needs a word, Gov, about Kemp Jones.
What?
You better talk to him yourself. He's in the canteen.
Sam, what's up?
Those photos Rod took of me and Vicky Hagen, Gov.
What about them?
Well, I thought I'd better warn you. There's a chance Kemp Jones might recognise me in them.
How come?
Me and Gary have just stopped him for jumping a red light.
So that's why I stopped the interview.
Well, we've had it, haven't we?
Uh-huh.
Ready for the restart?
Looks like it, Gov.
Thanks. Those photos are my client. You say they were taken Wednesday of last week?
Yeah.
Between 1 and 1:30?
That's right.
Do either of you remember the weather?
Why?
Rain all day.
So?
I'll have another look at them. I think you'll find it was a sunny day. Pavement's completely dry.
Could have been a break in the weather.
I think not, Mr. Deacon. You see, around that time, between 1 and 1:30, I was just round the corner from my client's address on my way out of court. I was drenched by a continual downpour. You can check with the Met Office if you don't believe me.
Oh, it was another officer who was on the obbo, wasn't it? Maybe he's made a mistake typing up the report.
Bit dodgy, Mr. Deacon. Means they're inadmissible as evidence.
Not necessarily.
It's going to have to be no comment from now on, I'm afraid.
Hello?
sorted.
Great.
Not a squeak and you're home and dry.
What now? It's all down to interview technique, I suppose.
Yeah.
I better take the lead then. So they might Tuffnell mean anything to you, Mandy?
No comment.
He's a friend, isn't he? Lives just around the corner.
I don't see the relevance.
You will in a minute. In fact, he's more than a friend, isn't he? Because during the course of our investigation, we've questioned Mike Tuffnell, and he informed us that he and you were in a relationship, a very close relationship by all accounts. It seems odd that he doesn't have a clue as to the nature of your professional existence.
Mike Tuffnell's knowledge of my client bears no relation to the case.
In fact, our information, Mandy, is that you and Mike Tuffnell took a trip abroad between September the 5th and October the 4th of this year. To Amsterdam, to be precise. True?
No comment.
We can soon check up on that, Mandy. We got the name of the hotel, flight numbers, everything. But you know what's puzzling me? Is that between the dates when Gavin Pierce was arrested and is known to have jumped bail, you and Mike Tuffnell were out of the country. So, according to your version of events, Gavin Pierce must have given you the drugs in Amsterdam. Doesn't quite add up, does it?
Once again, D.I. Deacon, you're inferring my client is lying.
Well, this is her opportunity to prove me wrong. What have you got to say to that, Mandy?
No comment.
Difficult for you to explain that one, is it?
Now you're making inferences out of my client's silence.
What about that silence, Mandy? What's the jury going to make of that?
My client's silence is within her rights.
You understand the caution, don't you?
Now you're harassing her into talking.
Do you want me to read the caution to you again?
I wish to speak to my client.
No, I don't.
Mandy, come on. Tell us the truth.
All right. I deal. The stuff's mine.
You spoke to the garage sergeant?
Yes, Notch.
And it's nothing serious. Good. Right. So what are we going to do about this Jane Douglas?
Don't know, Sarge.
Well, do you want me to have a word with her?
Not sure.
Well, we can't just leave it, can we? Shall I get Dave Quinlan to speak to her?
It'd be unfair to get him involved after what he went through in court. I suppose it's better in the end if it's me who talks to her.
Oh, you want to be careful. Remember how she reacted when you turned up at the funeral?
Yeah, I know, but I just think if I can get her on her own, away from all the relatives, well, we can sort something out.
You sure you're up to it?
I think so, yeah.
All right. Let things calm down a bit and then go and have a word with her.
It's not just the Pollack, Sarge.
How do you mean?
Well, on our way back, she had another go at me. I pulled over, got out of the car, so as to have it out with her, and she had other ideas. She slammed her foot on the pedal, almost ran me over. That's how I got this. Diving out of the way.
Oh, no, we're going to have to do something about this.
Yeah, I know, Sarge, but the thing is...
No, we can't have her threatening you like that. No, if we can't get this sorted out, someone's going to have to charge her.
I'm sure it'll make a difference if I could just talk to her. Let me try, Sarge.
All right, just once.
What else could I have done?
Stuck to the plan. No comment.
How was I to know they'd spoken to my boyfriend? They had me!
No, no! I told you before. With their screw up with the photos, there was a good chance I could have got the CPS to drop the whole case.
You heard what he said about the caution. I get less time if I plead guilty.
I thought the whole point was you couldn't face doing a stretch. I don't understand it, Mandy.
I know your game.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. If I plead guilty, it's all over in 5 minutes. You just want me to plead not guilty so you get a chance to show off in court.
And why would I want to do that?
Why else?
It's not me who profits, it's the firm who employs me.
Yeah, you just get a nice fat legal aid check.
Who told you that? How come you know so much about me?
You've got a reputation.
That's why, Mandy, you should have listened to me.
What happens now?
Your first offence, you'll get bail. Then there'll be a hearing in the magistrate's court, followed by your trial at the Crown Court.
I mean, what will I get?
You're still looking at 6 years minimum.
Isn't there something else you can try?
To be honest, Mandy, your only hope now is to do a runner.
Oh, how would I do that?
Kevin Pierce.
What of him?
It was me who helped him.
Helped him what?
Jump bail. I can do the same for you.
How?
I've developed a lot of contacts. One of them's gotten in at the passport agency. I can get you one if you like.
One what?
A passport.
Oh, what would I do with that?
Reinvent yourself, Mandy. Start over. Go up north, leave the country, whatever.
How much?
£1,000. Can you raise £1,000, Mandy?
It's possible.
Yes or no, Mandy? I can move fast on this if you like. I'll get you on a plane before your hearing at the magistrate's court.
I'm not sure.
Okay, forget it. It was just an idea.
All right, then.
I'm letting them go in a couple of minutes, Gov.
OK, Matt, thanks for the nod. Rod, we're on.
One mobile phone. Set of keys. Sign there, please.
Is that it?
What more do you want?
My £2,000 back would be nice.
You'll be lucky it's evidence.
Oh, well, it's worth a try.
And I need you to sign your bail form there and there. Back here next Wednesday, 10:30 in the morning. Make sure you're there.
Which way do we go?
I'll escort you.
We're honoured. Don't usually get a custody sergeant showing us out.
Well, don't get too excited. I'm going that way in any case. Pam, hold the fort.
Sarge.
This way. Who's she?
One who searched me. Bitch.
Right, Miss Kavanagh. See you on Wednesday.
I'm not likely to forget, am I?
You see? What did I tell you?
Nice one, Vicky.
OK. Mm-hmm. Richard Kemp Jones, solicitor. Gavin? What are you doing here? Not right now, Gavin. I'm speaking to someone else. A client. I'm right outside Sunhill Nick. Yeah, all right, Gavin. I'll meet you there in an hour.
Problem, Mandy.
What's that, then?
I'm going to have to meet up with you later, I'm afraid. Sort out your passport then.
Why? What's wrong?
Do you know who that was on the blower?
No.
Gavin Pierce, the one we said your Charlie belonged to.
So?
He's back in the country after another passport. The last one got nabbed by the Belgian police.
So?
I've got to see Gavin on his own. He does a lot of his own drugs, does Gavin? Gets a bit paranoid.
I've seen people before on coke. I deal with them all the time.
Yeah, but not Gavin. He's dangerous. That'll only be a couple of hours.
So he gets preferential treatment, does he?
It's not like that, Mandy. It's Gavin. He's heavy.
Do you want my money or not?
Don't worry, Mandy. I'll definitely get it for you.
But I need it now.
Mandy, please.
No! I'm first in line here. But I'll tell you what, Richard. When he turns up, you can tell him we're an item.
So far, so good. I think it is, or has she got an itch?
No, it's a signal. She wants us to back off.
You can't have seen her, surely.
She's just being cautious.
I'll hang back a bit more then.
Come on, get a move on.
Why? Where are we off to?
Jane Douglas.
What?
Just get in. Got the money?
Passport first.
What's wrong?
I'm just making sure they're not following us.
Who?
The filth. It's the sort of thing they do when a dealer comes out the nick. They've confiscated my stock. I might just lead them to a secret supply.
What?
Tell you what, the railway station's just down on the left. We can dump your car, jump on a train, then after a couple of stops, we'll swap to a minicab.
Did you see anything?
No. It's just a precaution. It's worth taking there.
You're right, Mandy. Don't want the old Bill sniffing around.
Besides, there's a photo booth at the station. I can get my picture taken with the passport.
Come on. Have they gone? Can you see them?
No. Well, hold it. Here we go. Here.
Yeah, I've got them. All right. I'll pull up over here.
Giving us a back-off signal again.
Follow her, Rod. Don't let her get too far away.
Right.
You've got a couple of quid?
It's all right, Gov, don't worry. Just getting some passport photos.
Stay with her all the same, Rod.
Do you want me to come in with you, son?
Nah, it's all right. I'll sort this one out. Yeah.
This him, Jane?
Yeah, it's him all right.
Mr. Stamp, Vinnie Prentice of the Daily Dispatch. How do you feel about arresting Simon Atwell's girlfriend for dangerous driving? What? You don't feel guilty then?
I'm here to have a private word with Miss Douglas.
You did well out of the court case though, didn't you, Mr. Stamp? Come on, Mr. Stamp, you're expected to go down. Weren't you surprised to have got off so lightly?
Everything all right down there, Tony?
Can I come inside, please, Jane?
I'm not inviting Simon to murder inside my house.
Do you agree with Jane Douglas that you're a murderer?
I just want to try and talk things over.
What things?
Personal matters, Jane.
Oh, we can talk right here. Say what you want on the doorstep.
Look, I didn't mean to kill Simon.
So you admit killing him then?
No.
But you just owned up. Isn't that a confession of guilt?
It was an accident.
But Simon's still dead, and all because you were driving too fast.
Jane, we went all through this in court.
But wasn't that all a cover-up?
Tony, come on, let's go back to the station, come on.
Why is it so few policemen get convicted for dangerous driving?
Look,
is it because of the Met closing ranks for one of their own?
All right, Dave. Let's go.
Walking away, Mr. Stamp. Too scared to face the press? Too scared to arrest her?
That's right, Mr. Stamp. Do what you came here for. Arrest me.
I didn't come here to arrest you, Jane.
Then just what are you here for, Mr. Stamp?
Do your job. I was driving like a maniac. I deserve to get locked up.
Tony.
No chance of a copper going down for dangerous driving, though, is there?
I was convicted, Jane.
5 points for murder. That what it says on your licence?
Jane, please. I can understand why you're still angry about the accident.
It wasn't an accident.
And I understand why you want to blame me.
Dear, except it was your fault then.
Please, Jane, let's come inside and talk.
You didn't even help him, did you, Mr. Stamp? You just ran him over and left him in a mess on the road.
Shut up!
No disrespect, Jane.
Heading towards the platforms.
What? Well, stay with them, Rod.
Excuse me. Yeah, it's legit. I'm a copper, right?
Excuse me.
Thank you.
Vicky, where to? Tickets to Barking.
I'm surprised you let me in, to be honest. Got the feeling you'd rather have tea with Jack the Ripper.
You were lucky. I'd had enough of that prat outside. But you're right about Jack the Ripper. It feels strange, you being here on your own. You don't seem much like a copper anymore. Well, like the one who took him away from me, I mean.
Must have loved Simon very much, Jane.
Still do.
This might sound odd, but I find myself thinking about the accident all the time. And then I start thinking about Simon, the life he had. Then I realise I'm thinking about someone that I never even knew.
Simon. He was special. I really mustn't go on about him all the time. I'm already beginning to lose all my friends.
I'd like to know about him.
Kind, thoughtful, all those things. I remember the first time I met him. It was after one of his gigs at the Bear's Head. He came up to me at the bar. I couldn't believe it. He was different from how I expected him to be. Really down to earth. Interested in what I had to say. Most blokes in bands just want to get into your knickers. Then he started asking me out. I felt I really trusted him, you know? He was strong and protective. Bit much sometimes, but... You'd never expect this from someone in music, but he didn't like parties much. He was into reading and poetry. It inspired him to write all his songs.
So you didn't go out much?
Hardly ever. I annoyed all my friends, but I didn't care. Simon was right. They were all immature. All they wanted to do was sleep around and have fun.
How about you?
Well... You make sacrifices, don't you, when you meet someone you love?
What do they think about you and him getting engaged?
That I was mad. That I was throwing my life away before I'd even started.
They might have a point, Jane. I mean, 19's very young to be getting married.
Well, you meet the right man, you don't hang about.
Even so, with your college to finish...
Now you sound like everyone else.
Sorry.
Simon knew what they'd been saying. I think that's why he asked me to marry him. He was scared that I was going to run off. I tried to reassure him that that had never happened, but... He was always getting into a panic. He got jealous and threw fits if I even went out without him. He once even hit some bloke who chatted me up at a party. I was mortified.
But you said you'd marry him all the same. Didn't you?
I said I was in court, so must be true.
Don't blame me if he isn't.
What do you know about it? It was all a mistake. I wanted to marry him. Just not yet.
So you told him the wedding was off? When was this? On that day?
Yeah. That day. We arranged to meet up in the pub. I hadn't intended to finish it, but as soon as I arrived, he started talking about this permanent job he got and how things were beginning to look up for him. Then he went on about how we could afford a mortgage and that we could get a house together. I suddenly realised it really wasn't what I wanted. I told him I needed space, time on my own.
What did he say?
He hit the roof. See him getting scared and was shaking all over. I took hold of his hand, but he just pulled it away and started shouting and swearing. I tried calming him down, but he wouldn't listen. He just carried on yelling and accusing me of lying and leading him up the garden path. Then he got out of his chair, telling me, oh, he never wanted to see me again. I tried calling him back, but he just walked right out, barging people out of his way. So I followed him. Then when I got outside, all he did was walk faster and further away from me. Then there were the sirens.
and the lights flashing. I yelled out his name, but he didn't listen. He was in a world of his own. By then it was all too late.
Sorry, Jane. I'm so very sorry.
What have you said to Miss Douglas, Mr. Stamp? Has she been arrested?
Excuse me.
Miss Douglas, have you been...
Did it go all right in there?
Just about.
What did you say to her?
Don't worry about it, Dave. It's all been sorted.
Great, isn't it? Used to be an old factory.
Wait till you see inside. I'm right up there.
All right, we'll keep trying.
No luck.
Have you tried his mobile?
No, it seems we've got it switched off.
For heaven's sake, we're almost at barking.
Hello, Rod. Sergeant Ackland here.
Yes, Sergeant.
Look, I've spoken to the firm of solicitors that employs Kemp Jones, and he's not expected in today, but they have given me his home address.
It's 15 Coviston Road, Canley Green, East 2.
All right, cheers, Sergeant. It's great. We know where he lives.
So, what do you think?
Yeah, it's a nice pad you've got here.
Used to be a photographer's studio. Still lots to do, of course. Be worth a packet someday.
No luck. He left 3 months ago, apparently. Comes round every now and again to pick up his mail, but that's it. No forward address, nothing.
Well, she's no idea where he's gone.
Down by the river somewhere, apparently. So now where do we go?
Sarah Jackson.
From now on, she's you, Mandy. The real Sarah Jackson's dead. Can't be Gavin already, surely. Good to see you, Gavin. Come on in. So, what have you been up to in Belgium to lose a passport?
What's that?
This is Mandy, Gavin. Come over and meet her. Don't worry, Gavin. Man is my girlfriend. She's cool.
You never said nothing about no girlfriend.
That's because I didn't know she'd be here. I've been helping out with a bit of the old interior design. Gavin, Mandy.
Hello, Gavin. Pleased to meet you.
I'd like to keep this business between the two of us.
Tell you what, Mandy. When do you step into the kitchen, make yourself a coffee? Leave us the tall business. Get all your bits and pieces, Gavin.
How long will this take?
A couple of minutes at most.
Sarge, it's Vicky. I need to get an urgent message to Rod Scase. Tell him I'm at Kemp Jones's place and Gavin Pierce has just turned up. It's the old warehouse, Gunner Street, top floor, flat 101. Okay, bye. You known Richard Long, have you?
You finished?
Not quite, Gavin.
Whose is this, then?
Another of my clients. Huh? Let's have it back, Gavin. Gavin!
Sarah Jackson. Another of your clients.
Sergeant Ackland here, Rod.
Yes, Sergeant.
I've had a call from Vicky. She's at Kemp Jones's place. It's off of Gunner Street, a converted warehouse.
Flat number 101.
And Rod, Gavin Pierce is there.
Right, hang on, Sarge. Left here, yeah. Gavin Pierce is with Vicky. Get some backup. Pierce is there. We'll need the whole relief.
I'm not messing you around, Gavin. Man is in a spot of trouble, that's all. You know how it is, buying and selling antiques. Now, the old bit are on to us, she has to get out of the country pretty quick. Just like you.
You're right, I'm not his girlfriend.
What's been going on?
It's all my idea. Richard's my solicitor. I've been nicked for selling drugs.
What kind of drugs?
Charlie, a kilo of it. What?
That's right. Once they got me nailed in the interview, Richard offered me the passport. I'm not going down for 6 years, no way.
I tried telling her I was meeting you, but she wanted the passport right away.
A dealer, eh?
That's right.
Whereabouts?
Sun Hill.
Who's your supplier?
That's my business.
I know all the dealers around here. Who are you?
Hello, Sun Hill Police.
Sun Hill Police?
What?
You set me up, have you?
Gavin, listen, mate, I had no idea! Just listen!
You listen!
Look, just calm down!
Shut up!
Gavin, listen, this is a bad idea.
What else are we going to do with her?
Tie her up, make a run for it.
Do me a favour.
Look, I'm not going to be done for murder.
You won't be. Open the door. It's the police.
You go up and join them. I'll try and get up round the back.
There's no way out, Gavin.
Yeah, there is. That's you. Don't come any nearer if you want her in one piece.
Gavin, listen to me. There is nowhere for you to go.
I said don't come any nearer.
Gavin, give yourself up. It's over.
I mean it.
Arresting you for assault.
You do not have to say anything, but it may harm your defence if you do not mention when questioned, sure. Something you later rely on in court. Anything you do say may be given in evidence.
Gavin Pierce. Dare say you'll be looking for a new brief.
All right, let me get. Easy. Ah! Easy.
Yeah. Vicky? Don't you ever try something like that again.
Yes, Gov.
Your personal safety always comes first.
Yes, Gov.
Don't worry about it, Vicky. They gave you a medal for bringing in Gavin Pierce.
Thanks, Tony.
Vicky?
This one's your collar. Dave?
Up you get.
You okay?
Yes. Thank you.
I was beginning to think he was going to kill us both.
Just as well he didn't. Be defending yourself, I take it.